You are trying to clear off enemy waves on each floor until you get to the top to defeat the Overlord. I have some many other examples of characters that I have thought of. I've also made some towers. I decided to split them up into genres. Army, medieval, and Aquarian. I had some concepts for certain rooms, such as the dining hall. It's basically going to be a grand room with a long corridor to the entrance of the dungeon, which will be goblins, witches, and the boss, King Goblin. Then I also have the bathhouse, where there'll be a lot of pools around, where Aquarian life form will pop out, and then pirates will swing off ships that will suddenly appear out of nowhere, with the final boss being Captain Shipshape, who will arrive on his galleon, the soap goblin. Another one I have is the treasury, where it's just lots of gold that will be teleporting in and out with dimensional portholes for an ever-changing level to keep you on your toes. And there will be enemies such as Mimic, Stormin, and Cross Dragon, Golden Dragon. And essentially the layout for each of them, so for example, this is the dining hall, and then this is putting it on the box with the back and front. Thank you. Any questions?
We've got an incoming tide, not much wind. I think we'll just motor sail. We're going to lose the wind shortly once we get past the Pārua Bay entrance. Heading for the chicks, which is top left hand corner of the screen. We're under bream here at the moment, so the wind's a bit all over the place. Bends it around to the east, but I'd imagine Once we get a bit further out, we'll be able to lay it. There's about a 1.5 meter long pair of easterly swell coming in. There's Peach Cove. Looks like one fizz boat there. The wind has swung around, so we're easily laying it. I will head for Lady Alice Island, I think. Maybe for the night. Here comes another gust off Bream Head. Good work out there. Probably quite small fish because I've only seen one gannet diving in. Now we're heading to South Cove, Lady Alice Island, which is here. I've laid in the track back to the entrance of Whangarei Harbour, and we have less cloud over top of Green Head. It is lightening up a bit. We seem to be deserted by the wind at the moment. What have we got? 4 knots. We are making progress again as the winds come up. So about possibly more northwest. Well, I can see it's going to be a frustrating trip in. We've got all the time in the world though, it's only 10 o'clock. Tide will be with us. The wind is up and down. Not surprisingly, because we're behind Bream Head now. So we're going to try and head back to our waypoint again. So we currently have, 8 knots of wind. But it's been up and down all over the show. Slow progress continues, so we've been on a broad reach, then a run, and now we've jibed. Who knows what's going to happen next? Here's the boat that was with us at the Chicks, so they're quite sensibly motoring back. It's a bit quiet about that without the autopilot, but there's no feedback on the steering, so we'll undoubtedly re-engage it soon. Tacking into the entrance, so we have the tide with us, so that's useful. I can just make out the Chicks way out there. Just past One Tree Point, the wind is going more and more west. But it's high tide, so we've pretty much got the whole harbour to play with. Home is over there, and there's Pārua Bay. Well, wind has effectively died. I wonder where it's going to come from next. West southwest it is. We're into the shallow side of the harbour. When it gets to half a metre, I'll tack. That's half a metre under the keel. heading for home.